A lack of oversight, due diligence, and communication is what a Senate committee says led to UH's failed Stevie Wonder concert and public backlash. Breanne Randall has more.
Joe, the committee's report released today calls for an audit of the UH system as well as annual training for the Board of Regents.
After listening to more than 13 hours of testimony over 2 days, the Senate Special Committee on Accountability came to a conclusion concerning UH Manoa's Wonder Concert scam.
The university staff that was involved with the concert all seemed to believe that it was someone else's responsibility to conduct due diligence and to make sure the university was protected.
The committee report released Monday says Jim Donovan failed to ensure those working under him conducted the necessary due diligence, that Virginia Hinshaw, the Manoa chancellor at the time, failed to provide oversight over the athletic department, and that President Marcy Greenwood failed to ensure the necessary checks and balances were in place.
That's what we're looking for, is solutions. We're not looking to blame anyone specifically, although the point that there have been no consequences to date remains a troubling factor. There has to be consequences.
The committee's report listed 18 recommendations, including a financial and management audit of the UH system, as well as having the Board of Regents receive annual training on Hawaii's Sunshine Law and Open Records Law.
At this point, it really is about really focusing on action. I think that's really what our university needs right now.
UH responded by saying that President Greenwood is on the Big Island and has not yet reviewed the report, but will do so as soon as possible.
That the University of Hawaii is facing a moral cliff, and that they have a responsibility to not only comply with these recommendations, but also to be more forthcoming to the taxpayers and the public and the students.
These recommendations will be turned over to the Senate Committee on Higher Education to follow up during the legislative session. Breanne Randall, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.